Καλησπέρα σας. Καλώς σας βρήκα. Good evening. Good to see you all. I knew some of you saw me last year by video, so I'm much happier to address you in person. The food was very good in South Korea. It's not much olive oil. The wine is not good at all. And more of a white drinker than beer. Sorry about that. It's good to see you all. It's an honor to be here. I'm sorry I couldn't be here with you last year at the Olympia Awards in Olympia. Some of you met me by video conference, but I think this is much better. So let me talk about some efforts we're doing to introduce and disseminate the Greek way of eating, a Mediterranean diet, to American populations of different types. If you take a look at this map, you can see that the average olive oil consumption per person in Greece is about 25 liters per person per year. In America, Great Britain, Germany, it's about 1 liter per year. Yet America is 9% of the world market. So you can see that just by doubling, if you could get the average American to consume 2 liters of olive oil, or even 1.5 liters of olive oil per year, there would be a tremendous increase in the market. So what can you do about that? One of the things is, even the people who try olive, they don't know how to eat it, unless one of them is explained. Maybe they think olive oil is just something, or you get a good olive oil in a very small bottle, you put a tiny bit on a plate, and you dip a little piece of bread in there, then you put the bad oil or some other white sauce or cream sauce on your salad, and you cook with another oil because olive oil isn't good for frying, it's not good for this, it's not good for that. In Greece, of course, we put olive oil on everything, and that's what we're trying to teach people. And it's a fundamental part of the Mediterranean diet. So, if you see the Mediterranean diet, or Mediterranean, I prefer the word Mediterranean lifestyle, which I'll explain a little bit later in the talk, but this is something which historically developed thousands of years ago around the Mediterranean Sea, and it persists to this day in various forms, although unfortunately many people are going away from what was the classic Mediterranean diet of the 1950s and 60s. But the key, which is appropriate for your event here, is that this diet only is native to areas which cultivated olive trees, because olive oil is the central part of this diet. In fact, in Crete and southern Italy and some other places in the Mediterranean, 30 to 40% of the calories consumed in the 1950s and 60s came from olive oil, which shows that fat is not bad, it's the kind of fat. So olive oil is a good fat, and the better the quality of the olive oil, even better. But it also, olive oil helps us eat vegetables and beans, osprea. So, cooking with olive oil and flavoring with olive oil, you can eat much greater qualities. Imagine the average American, they're trying to eat narrow pasta, lacanica, osprea. They completely taste it. There's no taste. And they're hard to swallow. Okay? But if you cook them in olive oil tomato sauce, they're delicious. They become much more nutritious. And there's a high consumption of fruits and moderate consumption of wine, white meats like fish, chicken, etc. This slide is very hard to read, don't even try to read it, but the basic point here is if you follow all the components of the Mediterranean diet to a high level, it's going to decrease your risk of heart disease by 30 to 40%. It's going to decrease your risk of cancer by 25 to 40%. It's going to decrease your risk of death 25 or 30%, and so on for Alzheimer's and many other problems. And it improves your quality of life. It improves everything from how you feel to sexual function to your memory, all these things. Another slide which is basically saying the same thing, but these are evidence just from clinical trials, which is what we call a higher level of evidence, but don't worry about that. Basically, everything you do, everything you feel, better with the Mediterranean diet, which is the typical traditional part of OCIP, and you can get the atrophy. Now, I was lucky to participate in this study with some Italian colleagues, and just one point on this one. So, if you follow all the components of the Mediterranean diet, so you're minimizing your consumption of red meat, you're having alcohol in moderation, you're using olive oil as your fat of choice, you're having fruits and vegetables frequently, nuts, all these things, you get a 30 to 40% increase in the risk of diseases. But if you isolate each component, which is what we did in the study, if you isolate each component, you can see that in yellow there, olive oil gives the biggest benefit, about an 18 to 20% increase in the risk of heart disease, just based upon olive oil. So olive oil, it's much better when it's taken in combination with the complete Mediterranean diet, but it is the most potent component of the Greek diet. So thank you for that, because I know we have a lot of producers here, and I think, you know, what you're doing is very important for people. I was very lucky to get admitted to Harvard and be able to stay there as a professor, and every day when I walk out of the parking lot, come to Savon, how did I get here? It's amazing. But the only reason I'm saying that is because everybody has heard Harvard. This was May 3rd, so it's only a week ago. This is the newspaper, not for the medical school, not for the School of Public Health. Harvard Gazette is the newspaper for the entire university. This came to the entire university, and okay, you don't see Greek diet, you don't see Mediterranean diet in the title, but it says, you know, to age better, to live better, you have to eat better. When you look inside the article, what did you find? The most common phrase in that article was Mediterranean diet. And you can even see at the bottom that our professors of nutrition, who are very well renowned, and they're, you know, probably the number one people in the world, said, yeah, there are a lot of good diets, including Asian diets and vegetarian diets, but there's no diet like the Mediterranean diet. So, eliminate the atrophy, pregnant. Now, you see the picture there, that's the chairman of nutrition, Frank Hu, who's a brilliant man. He's from China. He respects Greek diet. I think he wants to come to our conference in October. We had an event, which I'll talk about just a few days ago, Friday, with Chef Maria Lloyd, who many of you know from Greece. He was the first one to sign up to come with his wife, and his wife took home Maria's cookbook. And I mean, this is how much they respect your culture, what you do, what you produce. These are the smartest people in the world, and they're telling people what to eat, and they're telling them, you know, eat a Greek diet. We should do that more here, like croissant and tostaki. What about the orchimel garden? What about spanakopita? So, just show you a couple things. This is our school, and I'm not responsible for this. People like Professor Willett, Professor Hu, designed this over many years, but you can see we have a giant salad bar, and then you see what is the, there are many healthy oils, but you can always find olive oil in our school. You can always eat healthy. There always, you can eat anything you want. You can eat a hamburger, you can eat pizza, but there's always healthy choices. So last Friday, I brought Maria Lloyd to the school, and we did two things. One, the first was, during the lunchtime, she was the guest chef for all the students of our school. So Maria had started with a restaurant in Greece, now she has a restaurant in Manhattan. She's very famous. She's on TV in New York all the time. And we have a program called Heart and Plate, where you have a whole grain, you have some greens, you have a vegetable, you have a lean protein. So Maria was in charge of the station last Friday. She had a wheat berry salad, like salad with starry. We had gigantes, we had horta, so we had greens. Gigantes with the tomato sauce, everything prepared with olive oil. And a chicken with vegetables that was braised with kotobolu malakanka, pero sold out, okay? Even one student approached her and she was giving people things to try. Says, why do you like pizza? Let's just try my food. He wrote her an email, took her card, and he wrote her an email later, thank you for changing my mind. I feel better that I ate your food instead of pizza. My actual background is an occupational doctor, so I work with various types of working populations, and for over 20 years we work with firefighters and police, and they have a very, very high rate of heart disease on the job, especially heart attacks and sudden cardiac death. And we've described this in many different studies, but now we wanted to try to move towards prevention. So the first study we did with the working population, we were inspired by some of the studies in Spain and Greece in the past. We measured, we had a questionnaire which asked the firefighters how they lived, how they slept, how they exercised, what they ate at home, what they ate at the fire station, etc. And then we made up a scale based on other scales that are published, a Mediterranean diet scale, how close is their diet to a traditional Greek diet, okay? And you can see some of the point system. What we found basically is that the firefighters who were in the top 25%, whose diet most resembled the traditional Greek diet, the one that our Yayadas and Papudas follow, okay? They had a food, compared to those who were in the lowest, they had the most American diet, the most fast food, the most Coca-Cola, the most junk and garbage. They had a 40% lower risk of various disease risk factors. They had a 40% lower risk of weight gain. And all those things were true, even after adjusting for their body weight, how often they exercise, and all those things. So the diet is very, very powerful. We also did surveys of both career and volunteer firefighters, and just an example of typical American people. We gave them different diets. We didn't tell them the name, but they're all popular diets in the U.S. The magazines say, like, these are the five most popular diets in the U.S. And we gave a description of what they were. Consistently, they picked the Mediterranean diet as their favorite because it doesn't prohibit them from eating anything. It just tells them what to eat on a regular basis, how to eat in a more healthy way. So people, if you are willing to sell this and market it and package it in the right way, people are going to buy it. Okay? The market is waiting for you. Based on this, we were able to get a $1.5 million grant from the United States federal government. They have a program which is aimed to improve the health of firefighters. After 9/11, 2001, there's a lot of support for firefighters. There's always been a lot of support, but especially after that, for firefighters in our country. And this program arose, but they see the importance of this. They said, we'll take a risk on you and give you, we're going to give you $1.5 million to try to teach firefighters to eat like Greeks. See in the far right, this is the symbol of our study. We call it, they call firefighters in the United States the bravest, so we call it Feeding America's Bravest, Survival Mediterranean Style. And you can see the vial of olive oil is very prominent in the diagram. We have over 400 firefighters from Indianapolis, which is deep in the heart, the very center of America. So it's not Los Angeles, it's not New York, it's not Miami, it's not Boston. These are people who are really true, deep, middle Americans. All of this concept is very foreign to them, but they're embracing it. And I guess 400 people have signed up. 200 are in a control group, 200 are in the intervention, and they have access to a website. They've also got a lot of samples. My friend George Manzelos is here. He gave very generously some of his excellent olive oil from Greece and olives. There were also nuts that were donated from California, almonds, olive oil from Spain, whole grain, high fiber, high protein pasta from Barilla, from the Italian company, from their North American operation. And they have coupons from a large supermarket chain. And then they have a curriculum on this website. You see, we created, you've probably seen Mediterranean diet pyramids before. This one's created especially directly for the firefighters. But you can see that olive oil is featured not only in the very center at the bottom of the pyramid, but it's also off to the left. And the instructions are, you use olive oil for all cooking, you use it for all salad dressings, and take it to the table to add flavor to your food. That's the way to eat. You know, we had a conference at Harvard several years ago, and we gave people a lot of samples of Greek olive oil, small bottles the producers gave them. I can't tell you how many people, three and 6 months later, they said, Stefanos, oh, that's really good oil you gave to me. My wife and I, we put it on our salad every night, one second, you know, how is that possible? I drank that much olive oil in 1 week. You know, this is a whole family. And 6 months later, they have, so that's what I'm saying. They don't know how. We have to teach them how to use the olive oil. So that's what we're doing with the firefighters. We've created video courses. They have all kinds of materials on the website. And they're going to have visits from guest chefs, from firefighters, from chefs like Maria Luisa. We also did focus groups with the firefighters and their wives. We found out why they didn't eat healthy and whether they wanted to eat healthy and how we could help them eat healthy more. And we also had them give us their favorite recipes and then working with people like Chef Maria Lloyd, who was very generous and donated the time. We took their favorite recipes that were typical American things, so things that they were comfortable with, and we redid them Greek style, if you will. And we made them healthy. So for example, this is rolokimas. It's using ground meat from chicken and turkey, but it has olive oil. It has all kinds of vegetables, spices, different things, which are all healthy. So 3 years ago, we had this groundbreaking conference at Harvard, and this was the first time people saw the news, even in Greece. They said they brought Greek eating to Harvard. They brought Greece to Harvard. And many of our colleagues here, Professor Magiatis, many of you, Lofetis, were all there. We had the top nutrition professors from Harvard. We had chefs like Michael Psilakis, Diane Kokila, and it was very, very exciting. But this is something that's catching, let's say it's catching fire around. So I mentioned Barilla Pasta. It's not just an Italian company, it's a worldwide company. So they have a Mediterranean lifestyle program for all their employees worldwide. I just gave a talk on this subject at Vertex, which is a large pharmaceutical company in Boston. And they have a tremendous program. The cafeteria is very, very healthy. Seat, I'm going in a couple of weeks. It's a company in Barcelona, based in Barcelona. It's the largest auto manufacturer in Spain. So it's a Mediterranean country, but just like here, people are drifting away from the traditional ways of eating and they want to bring them back. So they're actually going to fund us to do a trial with them. They have three factories. They're going to put one factory on a diet that we give them and try to give them educational material, etc. And of course, I've already talked about the firefighter program. And we can easily adapt this to, our next plan is to adapt this to police. So we can change the hat, we can change a couple of the words, change a few things in the pyramid, everything's ready to go. I mentioned the event already that we have with Maria Lloyd. Let me just say a few more things about that. So I said we try to avoid the word diet. The word diet comes from the Greek word dieta. But in Greece, when we talk about Mediterranean diet, we talk about diatrophy, which is a way of eating, and that's what I'd like to promote more, a lifestyle, because a diet, especially, probably not just in America, but all over the world, it has the connotation that you're going to do something for several weeks, and then you just go back to what you were doing before. So this is something that you should do all your life, and that's important for the market as well, because people only eat olive oil for 4 to 6 weeks. That's not going to help you very much. But if they adopt olive oil as a way of eating for the rest of your life, that's a big deal. And the other thing is that, you see, everything in America is all theory. Everything in Harvard is theory. But what about practice? So we have clinical evidence, we have experimental evidence. What about empiric evidence? This is the Greek word, empiriki. And that was Maria. When Maria said she was going to say, Stefanos, εγώ είμαι empiriki. It's exactly. Θα μεταφράσουμε αυτά που κάνουν οι γιαγιάδες και οι παππούδες μας σε αυτούς. What happened? Just an example, we had over 70 people. It was a magical evening. There was a lot of energy in the room. One doctor who's a friend, typical middle American guy, he wrote to me, thank you so much for inviting me. After last night, we're putting away the butter. Next week, we're going out to get the best olive oil. One of the chefs that works at the university, she wrote to Maria, so Chef Maria, she said, changed my life. Instead of whatever kind of bagel or croissant or high carbohydrate, high sugar, high fat thing, bad fat thing she was eating, she had yogurt with berries and honey. Okay? So people are willing to embrace this if we teach them how. One more example. We had a fire chief from Alabama. If anyone knows Alabama, it's probably one of the worst diets in the world. Terrible fats, lots of them, lots of frying with bad fats, lots of sugars, lots of saturated fat, and very few fruits and vegetables. The time that this fire chief came to our conference 3 years ago, his doctor was increasing his medications for blood pressure. He was telling me he was going to need medications for diabetes, and his weight was going up, and he was feeling stressed out. He started making small changes in his diet after the conference by using olive oil instead of other oils. He said, I really didn't take anything away. I just started eating the better foods, and then I stopped eating the bad foods. You can see his blood pressure went down without medicines. His blood sugar went down. He lost weight. And we have a video testimonial from him about this on the website for the firefighters. And there are many more people like him. So just a couple words. I mean, we're not tired. We're not stopping. Next week, I will be at another conference, which is in Boston, run by some colleagues of mine from Italy. This is called Mediterranean Diet Roundtable. Last year with Professor Flynn, we were there in California. It's very successful. A lot of top flight American companies attend there. They have olive oil tastings. George and other people were there, so they know about this. And this year they have some excellent professors as well. So it's exciting that this is continuing. Lastly, and I do appreciate your attention, we are going to do the second edition of the conference we gave at Harvard. We're going to do it this time in Greece. It's been our dream to repeat this conference in Greece. So the second edition is going to be in Χαλκιδική, δεύτερη έκδοση του Συνεδρίου Μεσογειακής Διατροφής. Θα γίνει στην Χαλκιδική το Οκτώβριο. October 16th to 20th. I have two very talented dietitian colleagues, Theodora and Mary, and if you haven't gotten information on the conference or for sponsoring the conference, please see them on the way out. They'll be happy to give you some information. But we'll have very top professors there from Harvard, from Europe, from Greece, and elsewhere. And I think it will be another important event because this is one, it's hands-on. So we won't just give people lectures, we'll take them to all the oil mills, we'll take them to wineries, we'll take them to places where cheese and yogurt and things like this are made, because isn't it much better to see the Acropolis, to walk on the steps of the Acropolis than just to read about it in a book? The same thing is true with the Greek diet. If you can experience it hands-on, especially in Greece, which is the mother, then I think people will remember that, and it's more likely to change their lives. So please, if you can, support this effort and the other efforts. As soon as I sit down now, I'm still writing a proposal because we want to continue the study we're doing with the firefighters to make it nationwide for the entire fire service in the U.S. I just remind you of the opportunities there in the market. Σας ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ για την προσοχή σας. Και συγχαρητήρια σε όλους τους παραγωγούς που θα λάβουν βραβεία και σε αυτούς που δεν λάβουν, γιατί του χρόνου έχετε ευκαιρία άλλη. Thank you very much.